I have this little quirk of sorts where whenever I travel, I feel like I should keep a memory of that place. So I have every piece of crockery in my house has a story. So they're from some part of the world and some part of experience that is captured. So this is from Australia. And I went there for the Melbourne Film Festival and just fell in love with this little print. And I was like, okay, so yeah. This house was shown to me by a property dealer and he quoted a hugely high rent. You know, I wish I could get this house, but I really cannot afford it. And I left, and then after a month, a friend of mine said that there is something that I want to show you, and my friend owns it. And she got me to this house. And I was like, really? Will he like give me a discount? And then he said, let me think about it, because the gap was huge of what I could afford and what the ask was. A couple of days later, the Oscars happened and my little short documentary, period, end of sentence, won. And he texted me, oh my God, you won an Oscar. And I remember from Kodak Theatre, I had so many messages, but the only one that I was interested in, and I told him, I said, you know, I sent him a voice note saying, listen, my film has won an Oscar, but I want to come back to Bombay and be homeless. Can you please allow me to stay in your house? He's like, okay, come. How far you go with an Oscar? So yeah, that's how I got this house. Okay, thank you. So pick your swipe, the credit card game. Okay. Swipe your card for an AR/VR arm at your Mumbai studio or an independent production studio in LA. I'd swipe my card to get an independent studio in LA. Let's start with that. Okay. I was born in a big Punjabi family in GK2 in Delhi, and literally the memory of I have is all of them fighting over property and then my parents and me escaping that house and starting life from scratch in Surajkund in outskirts of Delhi. I think my parents really saw that as a sense of, you know, like something was taken away from them. But for me, getting out of a massive GK2 house where I didn't even know who the neighbors were, I was not allowed to step out to play, to go to buildings where we were, you know, there were many kids of my age. So yeah, that 8 years in Surajkund were magical for me. I have romanticized it in my head. And then I moved to Bombay. So I started working when I was like 16, 17, very early. And mujhe ghar khareedana. And I was obsessed about buying a house. Here, when I came in, I saw Aramnagar. How is there so much space here in middle of Aramnagar, huge maidan, beautiful, gorgeous, these houses. They all have so much character. And I found out the price of it and they were all very cheap because they were leasehold and they were not freehold. And my parents' life saving was, I think, around 20-25 lakhs at that point of time. And I called them and I said, mujhe ghar pasand aa gaya, kyaan pe hum khareed le? It was around 55-60 lakhs. And I was like, the whole thing is 60 lakh rupees. Do you think we can buy? He wired the entire money to me overnight without coming to Bombay. And I switched to then working on ads and I started line producing ads. I did a lot of commercials and a lot of international projects in those 6 months. And my dad also worked. He was a freelance property dealer. And then the rent started coming from that house, which gave my, for the first time, it gave my mother and my father like monthly sustainable income, you know, which was very, very empowering. And a year down the line, my mom got very, very unwell and her only dream was to buy a house in Delhi near GK1 Gurdwara. And overnight, I sold that house of one of the Aramnagar properties for 1.6 in 1 year. And took all the money, went to Delhi to buy a house for them. And I feel like at the age of 22, 23, I think, yeah, 22, I was able to buy my parents a house. Cruise holiday on the Symphony of the Seas or an expedition to the Arctic. Cruise holiday. Let's do that. I always want to do it. Aaj tak kiya nahi hai, toh let's do it. I was mid-20s when I was producing Gangs of Wasseypur. I used to just feel like mere ko baat hi nahi sun raha. I used to text my thoughts to my male colleagues in the room to pitch it, you know. So that had happened few times. So people used to just write me off because you're young, you know, and I felt like India is ageist. A lot of people here are ageist. And then just, you know, wearing a sari, wearing a double coat, wearing like that Nehru jacket over a kurta, just, you know, coloring hair white, wearing zero chashma. At that point of time, I used to put on an act to look older. I remember my neighbor, Mr. Kamlesh Agarwal, telling me that, you know, हम लोग एक बच्चों का ऐसे वीडियो बनाएंगे एंड तूने मास कम्युनिकेशन किया है, तू फिल्मों में काम करती है तो तू हैंडल कर ले. आई आस्क्ड हिम, आई सेड, हाउ मच डू यू वांट टू इन्वेस्ट इन दिस? ही सेड मे बी 50 lakhs. यू नो, आई जस्ट मेट एवरीबडी हु पॉसिबली हैड अ स्टोरी टू टेल एंड आई वाज जस्ट लाइक, मेरे पास 50 lakh rupees. So do you think we can work together? And in that journey, I also met this wonderful person, Mr. Subhash Kapoor. And we were hoping that 2007, the World Cup is happening, and we were on a schedule. We wanted to finish it on time and edit it on time, make Say Salaam India, and take it to the market for distribution just before the World Cup, so everybody can capitalize on it. India went for the World Cup in 2007, and the first match there, they lost. And the whole country is so heartbroken. The cinema guys have called our distributor and said, "Purana picture de to, ye cricket ka leke jao." And how do you justify that to an investor? You know, how do you reason this out? I went back to Delhi. I went to my school, Bluebells, and I asked my principal if she would allow all the kids to pay 50 rupees and come see a screening of my film. And the best part was like 1,000 kids, house full. You know, and I could hear them breathe with every ball. And you know, that excitement that just, and they were jumping by the end of it because you love those characters and they grow on you in that 2 hours of a journey and you want them to win and you're with them. And that is the power of audio-visual coming together and, you know, surround sound. I went back to my principal and I said, you know, kids loved it, and she also got great feedback. And I said, would you write me a letter? And then I took that letter to DPSR Kepuram and I did the same deal with Sangam Cinema right opposite. And 20 shows happened there, and then all other DPSs in Delhi got activated. And then I went to my college, and I was like, it takes a really long time to activate one school and one college and book the cinema. So if I get volunteers, I gave them all internship, offered them all internship letters from the studio that was distributing. And there was a day in my life jahan 15 show ikatthe chal rahe the. I did 300 plus shows like this and made all the money back for our investor, and just. And then I was like, okay, now I can legitimately produce. Producing a 100 crore film or endless finance for Sikhya's indie projects, any day, endless finance for Sikhya's indie projects. They have my heart. A lot of first-time films, the films that can travel, and I can make lots of them is my dream. So yes, let's do it. Largely, I also somewhere feel that it is stories that pick us, be it Masaan or be it Peddlers, you know, or Lunchbox or even Period End of Sentence. You know, one doesn't make it to go to a festival or to win an award. One makes it for impact, one makes it for intent. And then you have to just protect that intent till the last day and put it out there. So over a period of time, I've just learned to follow the path and to nurture it and show up in the best way, do what I know every day. Being a young entrepreneur, there is a lot of information that you have to learn. It didn't come easy to me. There are labor laws, there are tax laws. You need a full process and army of people handling that for you. And I'm very vocal about them to young producers that, you know, have a very good CA and understand what it takes, because the compliances are huge and you have to do business around them. I have learned how to invest money. I have a large amount of my investments is in mutual funds. 30-40% is spread, 30% is in shares. And I'm just beginning to invest in crypto. So that world is very fascinating. I used to just work for my rent and jo bachta tha FD. So wohi aata tha, wohi seekha tha. And of course, to, you know, be able to plan your life with insurances. Media rights for a Murakami book or Hans Zimmer music for Sikhya film? I've actually had a conversation about the second. So I'll go with media rights to the Murakami book. Let's do that. You know, it's one of those stories. I had a dependent card of my dad, and then when he left, I was like, Jini Rakhna credit card, you know. So it's an emotional story that I don't have a credit card. I have a debit card. I think a huge personal setback happened in my life, which I lost both my parents when I was 24. Made me absolutely fearless. Because the way I processed it in my own head was that literally the worst thing that could happen to me is done. You know, there's nothing that can be worse than this. And when that happened, I just threw myself in work, moved to Bombay, lock, stock, barrel, and just started working. And I said yes. I said more yes than I could handle or I could chew. I was like, I'll do everything. Overcommitted myself so I don't have to think about any personal tragedy and just be completely involved in work. So for me, it became about lives that I can impact, things that I can do in whatever years I have, in whatever days I have on this earth, and live a very fulfilling life, because our time here is short. It's limited. And I saw that happen very close to me. So, you know, so it made me a huge risk taker. Talking about money is important. The more we discuss money, the more we learn about it, the more it grows. You're more aware. I hope this conversation helped you and you gained more knowledge in any which way through my journey. Do like, share, and subscribe to Cred's YouTube channel.